Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 15 has hundreds and hundreds of changes in it and new features as well. However, there are still some that will not be available at the initial launch of iOS 15 on September 20th. So when Apple releases it to the public, they've actually decided to remove some of the features at the initial launch time. So I wanted to go over all of the features that will not be in the first launch of iOS 15 and might be coming to iOS 15.1, iOS 15.2, or later on. And the first thing you've probably already heard about, the CSAM photo scanning. That has been delayed over a lot of concern from different organizations, over 80 organizations, from universities to different companies that are concerned about its integrity over time or possible abuse based on if someone could get a hold of it later on. So Apple is reevaluating that, and it may never launch on iOS. However, at this point, it's just temporarily delayed. They have not said when they plan to re-implement it or change that up at all, but maybe it will be in future updates, but it will not be available at the initial launch of iOS 15. Now, the next thing you've probably already heard of, and it was a huge feature that's pushed quite a bit by Apple, and that is SharePlay. It gives you the availability to share music and video and different things while you're on a FaceTime call. In fact, it's on the main page of Apple's website. So if you go to apple.com and then you look at iOS, maybe we'll go to iPhone, and then we scroll over to iOS, you'll see a preview of iOS at this time or just information about it. And as I scroll down, the first thing it mentions is SharePlay, but they've decided to delay this. So that's something that I thought was quite surprising, since it's probably the standout feature that a lot of people were curious about. That also includes not only SharePlay, but also screen sharing when on a FaceTime call. In early betas of iOS 15, you could share your screen just like you can record your screen now. You could share it with other people while you were using FaceTime. I even tried this with my brother. He could see my screen, no problem. It worked fine. But for some reason they've delayed it. So you'll see it says watch together, listen together, also share your screen. And all of those things have been delayed as far as SharePlay goes with iOS 15. Now, whether or not that's coming with iOS 15.1 or later on, we don't know. They've just said it will be available later on. Now, another thing I haven't heard much information about has to do with maps. So if we go into maps, now within maps, there's a lot of new features and updates in iOS 15. However, one of the things they've actually completely removed from notes and don't mention anymore at all is a maps nighttime mode. Now, whether or not dark mode counts, I'm not sure, as you can activate dark mode and you'll see it sort of switches to nighttime, but it's still not the same thing as sort of nighttime navigation or more. So you'll see as I zoom in, it's still sort of nighttime here, but there is no nighttime mode mentioned as a standout feature where it was originally mentioned in the iOS 15 notes. They've completely removed that. Another thing they've removed altogether has to do with Home. And Home is supposedly going to support Matter in the future. Matter is a standard for different communication across devices, and Matter support has been delayed. They haven't mentioned when it will be back, if it will be back, but it was supposed to be launching with iOS 15, and it's been removed from the notes of iOS 15 on their website. So it's nowhere to be found in any of the feature lists of iOS 15 now, as it was before. Now, something a lot of people are looking forward to is in the Wallet app, there's now digital IDs. Now, this is sort of hit or miss with the launch of iOS 15, as it really is dependent on your state and country whether or not Apple can implement it based on local laws. So it is coming to some states upon launch, but most states are not available. So in your wallet, you'll be able to add a digital ID that uses technology on the phone to verify it's you and scans your license to make sure that it's actually you inputting your information properly. And then you can use your phone as an ID as well, so you don't need to carry everything with you. That's something that will be implemented in the future with the TSA in the United States for traveling via flights and more. But right now, it will only be available in two states at launch, it looks like, or others, but they haven't said when. So Arizona and Georgia seem to be the first. So you'll go into Wallet. When you tap on Add to Wallet, you'll have the option for a digital ID eventually. And it will eventually be coming not only to Arizona and Georgia, but also Connecticut, Iowa, Kentucky, Maryland, Oklahoma, and Utah. But no date has been given for that. So we're still waiting for that. Whether or not it will be available in more states, again, is up to the local government and whether or not they feel that the ID is secure enough to keep on the device. So whether or not that becomes a standard across the United States or not remains to be seen. But right now, it will only be for the states that I mentioned. As far as countries, they haven't mentioned any other countries as well. So it's available at launch, but only a little bit. So that's something to look forward to in the future. Now, another thing that we're waiting for is digital legacy. With iOS, to request to unlock a phone after someone passes away or that you need to gain access to is very difficult to do. There is a website that you can do this on. So if you go to Safari, you can go to digital-legacy.apple.com. And at that website, you can request to unlock a phone, but you'll need additional information. They do have a way to recover within the phone, but eventually this will be brought into iOS 15. But if we go to our settings and then you tap on your ID at the top, under passwords and security, you'll see we have account recovery. If I tap on account recovery, under account recovery, you can add a recovery contact. This is still not the same as a digital legacy or the request for a full access to whatever you had on your device, such as your photos or other important information, such as passwords to get into things that you may need to get into if someone passed away. So that will be coming in the future. Right now, it's not available. In fact, they removed it in beta 5 and said it would be added at a later date. So it is coming eventually, but right now it will not be at the initial launch of iOS 15. Now, another thing they've talked about that they're not going to have at launch is App Privacy Report. So if we go into our settings, go down to Privacy, go all the way down to Record App Activity, we have a report we can run that shows us app activity if we turn it on. However, if we save this, it just saves to a file. It is not the actual interface that they showed before, similar to what we have with a privacy report in Safari. So you can see that you have an interface that would show you all of the different activity between apps, but that is not active in iOS 15 yet and should be coming at a later date. So that's something that won't be there at launch, but will be there eventually. Now, another thing that unfortunately will not be there at launch is universal control, and that has to do with the iPad. So on the iPad, you'll have universal control. And what that allows you to do is use a keyboard and mouse between your iPad and a Mac running macOS Monterey. So you'll be able to use a Magic Trackpad or a mouse that's paired to not only your iPad, but also your Mac, and then be able to seamlessly go between them. You bring the cursor over to the edge and it jumps to your iPad or jumps back to your Mac. That's something that will be coming later on. And the reason it will be later on is macOS Monterey is not launching the same day as iOS 15. Typically, that's delayed a couple weeks. It might be delayed a month. We don't really know, as Apple has not given a release date for it. But when that's available, maybe they'll make it available in iOS 15.1 and iPadOS 15.1 on this device. So hopefully we'll see more of that later on. One final thing that won't be coming is CarPlay 3D Maps. So it looks like they've actually delayed this. So if you're using maps and navigation on CarPlay, the 3D Maps option will not be there. So where you have 3D Maps that are really nice in navigation on maps, if you're using your phone, when it's connected to maybe a CarPlay device, it won't show that. It could be due to processing power or something to do with the latest CarPlay devices, and it won't be carried over to previous CarPlay devices. We don't really know, but it looks like that's delayed at this point. So all of those things will be available, it seems, at some point, unless they've removed it entirely and left it for iOS 16, or maybe just a later version of iOS 15. Hopefully we get universal control very soon. And of course, SharePlay, which was a key feature of iOS 15, is very surprising not to have that at launch, since it seemed to work okay in later betas. So at this time, we'll see it a little bit later. Again, they have not said when that will be, but typically after Apple releases iOS 15, you'll have multiple versions within the next month or two. So look for that if you don't already have those. And so those are all the things not releasing right away to iOS 15. If you know of any others, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. Now, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.